Hi, in this video, we're going to learn about if statements and conditionals in Karel. So let's talk about crashing in Karel. When we make a mistake in our program, it's called a bug. For example, if Karel runs into a wall, that would be a bug. So to prevent these bugs, we can ask questions about Karel's world. We might want to ask, is Karel's front clear? Are there any balls in Karel's current position? Is Karel facing east? And so the way that we can ask these questions is using conditions. So introducing conditions. A condition is a function that returns a true or false answer. So let's take a look. Here is the list of Karel conditions. We can ask, is the front clear? Using front is clear. That will either be true or false. We can ask, is the left clear? Using left is clear. Right is clear. Are there balls present? Is Karel facing north? These are all questions Karel can ask about his world. Is Karel facing west? And based on the answer to these questions, we can do one thing or another. So the first main use of conditions is for if statements. And we say, if some condition is true, then let's execute some code. But we only will do that code if that condition is true. Let's look at some examples of real live if statements. So here, let's say if it is raining, then you can use an umbrella. That would look like if it is raining, then use an umbrella. So if your room is messy, then you should clean your room. So if your room is messy, then clean your room. In Karel, what does that look like? If the front is clear, then you move. You wouldn't want to move if the front is blocked. That would be a bug. And I want to highlight one specific thing, this open and close parentheses after front is clear. That's because front is clear is a function, and we are calling that function. So let's head into our code editor and look at some if statements. Here I've written a small program that has Karel move twice. And when I run this program, Karel moves and then crashes into a wall. Well, the thing that we need to do is we really should only move if the front is clear. So we write if front is clear, open parens, close parens, and then close the if, open curly, close curly, back, enter, enter. Now we'll move that move inside the if statement. So everything in the if statement should be only one tab in. You can have multiple things in an if statement. So now if we run this, move, and then we don't move because the front is not clear. Let's try looking at one more example of an if statement. Here, I have Karel try and take a ball, move, and then take another ball. And when we run this, oop, we crash because there are no tennis balls to pick up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write a function called safeTakeBall. And that will only take a ball if there's a ball there. So we say if ball is present, then takeBall. So instead of just take ball, I'll call safe take ball. And then when we reset and run this program, we see that Karel, let's slow it down a little bit, doesn't crash. Because when we call safe take ball, we say, are there balls present? There aren't, so then we just move, and then we continue. So that is an introduction to if statements.